all to GJ Tech School Grand Journey into Learning Civil Engineering Basics and Concepts. Firstly, I would like to thank my teachers, organizations I have been worked with, and my colleagues and friends, to my wonderful students, and to the divine energy. Learning Concrete Mixed Design, a series of topics under concrete technology. Concrete is nowhere a common conventional construction material which was used to make or prepared by mixing up cement, aggregate and water. Nowhere today concrete has become so simple. Concrete nowadays is a product of composite materials or product which houses itself with an alternate materials to cement, alternate materials to aggregate, and also alternate materials called as chemical admixtures, which would enhance a lot of properties of concrete in its fresh state and hardened state. So concrete mixed design by itself has become a unique topic of study and field of research for the modern concrete technologists. Concrete mixed design, in simple way, it can be defined as mixed proportioning of concrete to determine required characteristics such as fresh properties, hardened properties, and durability. Concrete properties is called as mixed design. Mixture proportioning refers to the process of obtaining quantities of concrete ingredients to achieve the specific characteristics of the concrete. So what are the ingredients of concrete that make or influence in obtaining the specific unique concrete? Proportioning quantities such as air, aggregates, cement, water, and admixtures and their alternatives is called as concrete mixed design. Concrete is a mixture. Designing a mixture brings out a lot of types of concrete in modern days, such as concretes which are having different strengths, concretes which are having different unit weights, concretes which are more resistant and less resistant to the chemical attack and environmental attack, and also concretes which serve the specific purpose of structural requirements. Hence, concrete ingredients needs to be understood thoroughly before we go into designing the concrete mix. Cement and cementitious materials. Cement is primary ingredient of concrete. Different kinds of cements can be classified as ordinary Portland cement and blended cements. In modern terms, they are called as hydraulic cements. A cement is a material which sets and hardens to a hard rock or stone kind when it is reacted with water. So to understand blended cements, there are two kinds of blended cements: Portland pozzolana cements and Portland slag cements. These blended cements are manufactured by mixing the dry clinker of Portland cement or with the pozzolana materials or slag materials to bring about PPC and PSE type of blended cements. These pozzolana materials, to understand, are initially having no cementitious nature or behavior until they react with water. And when the Portland slag cements are manufactured, to be noted point is the Portland slag cement, the slag material contributes to 60% of weight of the Portland slag cements. So what are these pozzolana and slag materials are, such as fly ash, slag cement, silica fumes, riser ash, and metakaolin. So the next is supplementary cementitious materials. These are also called as mineral admixtures. What are supplementary cementitious materials? The supplementary cementitious materials are, as you can see, the same pozzolanas and slag materials, but in this case they become supplementary to cement while mixed proportioning for concretes. That means externally they are mixed or replaced by certain portion of cement reduction in the mixing process. Hence they become the mineral admixtures. They are used as admixtures and they are not used during the manufacturing process of cement. There are two kinds of SCMs, they are natural pozzolans. Two kinds of SCMs are chemically active mineral admixtures and microfiller mineral admixtures. To notable point, the differentiation or classification of these SCMs comes from their particle size and the specific surface characteristics what they exhibit. So chemically active mineral admixtures are more reactive nature, and they tend to decrease the workability and setting time of concrete as they are highly reactive, but they increase the heat of hydration. Whereas microfiller mineral admixtures increase the workability or delay the setting time, but they decrease the heat of hydration. So depending upon specific requirements, we can do use both kind of supplementary cementitious materials in order to curtail or reduce the cement content and make the concrete economical. To discuss about aggregates, there are two kinds, as all of us know, as basics, coarse aggregates, which are having particle size higher than 4.75 mm, and fine aggregates, which are having particle size lower than 4.75 mm. To discuss about coarse aggregates, there are four kinds of coarse aggregates that can be used in preparation or mixed proportioning of concrete. Those are uncrushed gravel or stone, which are having more rounded or which are always water worn because they are found from the natural source of river or sea source, which are quarried or mined from the seabeds or river beds. Next type is crushed gravel or stone. These are more preferable and having angular shapes, which are having clear edges, and these are sourced from or shaped in the quarry from different types of rocks. Partially crushed aggregates, these are mixture of the quarry material or crushed aggregates and the natural aggregates, or sometimes they are also available naturally in irregular shapes, hence they are termed as irregular aggregates. Blended from quarry and also they are naturally obtained. Next type of aggregates are processed by or manufactured. So here they are having shapes flaky or angular. It means that apart from the other types of aggregates, these are manufactured from the various recycled concrete aggregates and various slag contents from different metal mines. Hence, they tend to be more irregular or more lengthy, called as elongated, or more flaky chips like aggregates are obtained per sample. Hence, they are termed as flaky or angular expected. So to understand the classification of different types of aggregates based upon their shape and size, we need to know two types of indexes, that is flakiness index and elongation index, that are determined in the lab when the aggregates are tested for their shape parameters. The flakiness index gives the proportion of large portion of the aggregate sample having more flaky materials, and elongation index determines the aggregate sample to a category where large portion of the aggregates are of very lengthy in nature. So based upon this index, we can determine whether the aggregates are suitable or not suitable for concrete. So manufactured aggregates are blast furnace slag, as we see here. They are having a mixed shape characteristics of rounded and some portion is angular, and recycled concrete aggregates are mostly like rounded, as we obtain have no control of their size or shape that we obtain during the process or manufacturing. Coming to fine aggregates, there are five different kinds of fine aggregates classification. Natural type of fine aggregates, crushed fine aggregates, mixed type of fine aggregates, manufactured fine aggregates called as manufactured sand, and other non-natural sands. So what are other non-natural sources? are iron slags, granulated iron slags, steel slag, copper slags, and construction demolition waste. Sometimes these also can be used as fully replacement to the fine aggregate or partial replacement to the fine aggregate, but they have to be used in a maximum limit of 50% for preparation of plain concrete and 25% for proportioning of concrete for RCC structures. That is the portal guidelines. So what are natural aggregates, fine aggregates? These are available sands from the natural water sources, and crushed sands are prepared from different rocks and coarser size of rocks and stones, and they are crushed to the required specific sizes of fine aggregates in a quarry. Mixed sand comprises of crushed and natural aggregates mixed together for preparation of concrete, and manufactured sand is prepared from the hard granite and washed thoroughly, and they are proportioned to the required size. They are mostly cuboidal in shape. The particle shape will be cubic in shape, and they are mostly used and they enhance the strength of concrete since they are having a good strong particle strength. So differentiating the fine aggregates, we need to know certain parameters which classify or differentiate each type of fine aggregates. That is silt content available in the type of fine aggregates, texture of the particles, fineness modulus, workability, strength of the sand, and setting time of concrete when they are mixed with the cement, water absorption properties. These are the basic properties or factors based upon which we can identify or bifurcate between different types of fine aggregates. Next ingredients we are discussing is chemical admixtures. Chemical admixtures are having the minimum volume in concrete compared to the other ingredients of concrete. Chemical admixtures work upon the fresh properties of concrete, so they are very important in terms of changes required in the fresh concrete properties without altering the other ingredients or mixed design parameters. So chemical admixtures are available in liquid and powder form, and they are classified based on their function in the concrete mix as plasticizers, water reducing admixtures, air entraining admixtures, accelerators and retarders. Plasticizers are further available as super plasticizers and retarding type of super plasticizers. Super plasticizers induce very high workability to the concrete by reducing water to a very high extent, that is up to 30% reduction in water content can be expected by use of super plasticizers. Retarding super plasticizers are used when there is a requirement of retarding the final setting time of concrete and there is a requirement for prolonging the workability. So when the concrete is mixed and before it is casted in site, it needs to be transported, and it takes certain duration where concrete tends to reduce its workability or it will tend to set early. In that case, retarding superplasticizers play a vital role. Water reducing admixtures are used where we have to maintain a fixed value of water cement ratio and we need an enhancement or increase in the workability. In that case, water reducing admixtures can be used to increase the workability to certain extent. Air entraining admixtures are used extensively for air entraining concretes. Whereas mass concretes are concerned, we need to take care of durability aspects. So in that case, air entraining admixtures induces bubbles through their chemical reaction and increases the plasticity of concrete. Whereas these air bubbles induced in the concrete in the later part play an important role of resistance, additional resistance given for freeze and thaw, and also will reduce the de-icing salts in the concrete. So Hence, air entraining admixtures are also important. Accelerators will reduce the setting time by increasing the rate of hydration of cement. You can observe here the plasticizer doesn't affect the rate of hydration of cement. As an overall compound, they will increase the workability without touching or altering any setting time of cement. But accelerators will increase the rate of hydration and retarders will decrease the rate of hydration. So when there is a requirement of early set and early strength gain, requirement is there, we can go for an option of using accelerators. And when we need to delay the setting time to few minutes, then we can all opt for retarders. So chemical admixtures can be overall kept in mind as the admixture which will enhance or work upon workability, and admixtures which are concerned about durability, and admixtures which are concerned about the setting time of concrete. Water content and air content in concrete. So water quality and the soluble salts and the solids that to be present and not to be present is governed with the IS 456 standards table 1, and water should be complying with those standards. And influencing factors to water content which tends to reduce the water content are increase in maximum size of aggregates. When the size of aggregates goes on increasing, that is from 20 mm to 40 mm, 40 mm to 80 mm, as the size goes on increasing, then the water demand or water content tends to reduce. So they are interrelated. While designing, this plays a major role. So we should have a clear idea. A decrease in water cement ratio will also decrease the water. Decrease in workability, that is plasticity reduces as the liquid content or water content reduces. Use of rounded aggregates also tries or tends to reduce the water content. So as the aggregates becomes more angular in shape compared to rounded aggregates, the water tries to reduce when the rounded aggregates are used. So water reducing admixtures also will reduce the water content in the concrete. So parameters which increase the water content in concrete are cement content. As it increases, so would demand more water. As the temperature goes high, obviously the concrete demand or thirst for water increases, and angularity of aggregates increases also demands the water. So decrease in coarse aggregate and fine aggregate fraction. So here, what happens when the coarse aggregate to fine aggregate fraction decreases? As we can see, when it decreases, the fine aggregate portion will increase the total aggregates. So as the fine aggregate increases, we can understand there will be an increase in water demand in concrete. So entrained air. So what is the role of entrained air in concrete? Entrained air enhances the plasticity and workability of a fresh concrete. It improves the durability characteristics of concrete in resisting the freeze and thaw and other chemical reactions. Reduces segregation and bleeding. So segregation and bleeding is a major problem in high strength concretes when there is overdosage of chemical admixtures, and there is a high variation in temperatures, and when there is an excess water in the concrete. So this all can be handled when we have proportioned the air content in a proper manner, or if entrained air is induced, these problems can be handled in a better way. So this can be done by using a air entrained chemical admixtures, also by inducing the air volume in concrete. Also, air entrained concrete will reduce the de-icing of the important salts in concrete. So the factors influencing the entrained air are nominal size of aggregate and grade of concrete. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, support and share, and also keep in touch with my GJ Tech School. And next topic, don't forget to continue to watch the Concrete Technology series, where I'll be discussing about the concrete mix design methodology and solving the live problem as per the Indian Standard Code 10262 2019. Thank you very much.